We are going to create a Laravel blog, and when we are finished, we will purchase a domain and a hosting package, and then we will deploy it. And after all that, we are going to repeat the same using live wire. So let's see how the blog looks like before we create it. And this is the blog. And here you can notice that when we are at homepage, the link is bright and the rest are dark. And when I click about, the link becomes bright and the rest are dark. We are going to learn how to do that dynamically using Laravel. Let me go back to the homepage. Then when you scroll down, we have latest blog posts. So we are fetching the latest blog posts from the database, and we are only fetching the latest 4 blog posts. Here they are, and you can see we have the timestamp when it was created, we have the author, and we have the title. And when you click on any title, it takes you to that blog post. So you can see here, and then at the bottom we get related blog posts. And when you click on any, it takes you to that blog post. And notice something else, the URL. Here we are showcasing the slug. So we are searching this post using the slug. This is good for search engine optimization instead of using the ID. Another thing, the slug is unique. So when you create another title, another post rather, with the same title as this one, it will generate the same slug, but the ID will be different to make it unique. We are going to do all that using Laravel. So from there, let's check the blog page. This is the blog page where we have all the blog posts. So here we are fetching the latest 4 blog posts, but you can change that according to how you wish. Then here down here we have pagination. So when you click here, you go to page 2, and you can see the posts that on that page. So in my case, I have very few blog posts. So if you had many, then you'll have more pages here. So let me go to back to page 1, and here you can filter the blog posts using categories. So when you click help, you get all the blog posts associated with the health category. When you click entertainment, you get the posts associated with that. Sports, you get the posts associated with that. Nature, the same. If you want to see all, you'll see all the posts. You can also search. You can come here and say immune, then search, and we get 2 blog posts. So here we have immune, but here we don't have immune because the immune word is in the body. So you see, it's here. So when you're searching, it's always looking for that word in the body or in the title. So I'll go back. And if you try to search something that does not exist, let's search for something that does not exist. So I can just come here and say honest politicians. Search, you get this. Sorry, currently there is no post related to your search. That's all about the blog page. I believe I've not forgotten to mention anything. Then when you go to about page, this is just a static page, so we are not going to write any Laravel here. Contact page, here you can come. Notice in my Gmail, there's no any new email. So you can just come here, provide the name. Let's see how it works. And I can say dan@gmail.com. Subject, I can say internship, application. For the message, I can just write anything, dear Madam, hi, my name is what? My name is so and so, and I would like to blah 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 blah. Let's send. Submit. Then it's loading. Let's wait. Then we get a flashback message. Thank you. We'll be in touch soon. Let's check our email. Refresh. We sent it twice. So here is the email. You have the subject here, internship application. You open it, you have the message. Here's the message, the name of the person who sent it, and their email. We are going to learn how to do that using Laravel. So now let's check the backend. So I'll come here. I will register a new user. Let's call that new user email. Let's call it new user at gmail.com. I'll use the same as a password to save time. Then register. When you register, you're taken directly to your dashboard. And if you want to log out, you just click here and log out. But we don't want to do that. So here you can create a post, you can create a category, you can so let's create a post. Come here. You can create a post. You can say when you protect nature. When we protect nature, then nature protects us. Choose a file, choose an image, option, I'll put that in category nature, then I can write something here, nature needs our protection. Then post. Then you get a flashback message, post created successfully. And here we have the post. And notice something. Here I have the option to edit and delete because I'm the one who has written this post. But I can't edit or delete this because I'm not the author of this post. So we are going to do, to implement that using Laravel as well. So you can also edit the post. So I can come here and say edited. Then you have to choose the file again. Then if you want, you can change the category. And notice that the previous category is pre-populated. For the file, it's not pre-populated because of some security reasons. That's why we don't have that feature in Laravel of old value in files. Then here, notice we have our body. It's already pre-populated, so we can add some texts and then you can submit. And after that, we get post edited successfully. You can check the post. Here it is, edited. Let's check the body. And here, nature needs our protection, edited. And then here we have related posts. So Nairobi is the only city in the world, the national park. You can click there. So when you're here, you can see related posts, the posts that are related to nature, and we only have one. So let's go back to our blogs. So we've seen that we can edit and we can delete. I think that's all. If I've forgotten anything, we'll cover it during the tutorial. Again, let's go back to the dashboard. We can create a category. I can come here. I can say new category. New category. Submit. Their category created successfully. And here it is. I can as well edit it. Can come here and say edited, submit. There we go, edited. I can delete it as well. It's deleted. I've just remembered that we did not delete a blog to see how that works. So I'll go to blog. And I'm able to see this because I'm logged in. When I log out, you can't see this, edit and delete. So if I try to click delete, there we go, post deleted successfully. Back to the dashboard. I think that's all. In case I've forgotten anything, we'll cover it in the tutorial. So in the next video, let's get started working on this amazing project. Cheers.